क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेनड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू StudyIQ। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एरा दैट इज एयरपोर्ट्स इकोनॉमिक रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट अमेंडमेंट बिल 2018। एरा स्टैंड्स फॉर Airports Economic Regulatory Authority. The AERA Amendment Bill of 2018 aims to amend the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India Act 2008. So there was already an AERA Act of 2008 and this bill tries to amend this act. So why there is a need to amend this AERA Act of 2008? Because of rising air traffic. In the year 2008 when AERA was passed, the air traffic in the country was less. So now we are experiencing a rising air traffic in the country. And because of this increasing or rising air traffic, India has emerged as the third largest domestic aviation market in the world. So we are the third largest domestic aviation market in the world. And one reason for this is the population of the country. So we are the second most populous country in the world. And this is one factor that has contributed to rising air traffic in the country. Other reasons can be international migration or migration within the country, urbanization, increase in the standard of living, increased rates of education, skill development. This will help in finding better jobs, so better job prospects, etc. All this have contributed to increase in the demand for air travel. So this has increased the air traffic within the country, and therefore there is a need to amend the already existing AERA of 2008. So the increasing passenger load demands for better regulatory structures, and therefore the new amendment is introduced. The AERA Amendment Bill of 2018 is introduced in the Lok Sabha on July 18th. So this was introduced in July 18, 2018 during the monsoon session of the parliament. So Minister of State for Civil Aviation has introduced this bill. So in this lecture we would be seeing what is AERA, what is the need for the amendment, and also what are the proposed amendments, and also we will see the provisions of the bill. Let us start. First of all, coming to what is AERA. AERA stands for Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India Act. So this was passed in the year 2008. So as we said, there is already an existing AERA Act that is in the year 2008, and due to the increased demand and changing dynamics, there was a need to introduce an amendment bill, and this is introduced in 2018. So we have introduced the amendment bill because of the increased demand for air travel. More the traffic means more regulation is required, or better regulation is required. So with increase in the dynamics and increase in the number of passengers who are dependent on air travel, the new AERA amendment bill has been introduced. Coming to the 2008 AERA, the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India Act 2008, it had aimed to establish an independent aeronautical regulatory authority. So independent, the word is very important, independent aeronautical regulatory authority. So the purpose was to introduce an authority which would be an independent authority and which would be able to regulate the aeronautical sector. And the purpose of the authority was to work for the protection of the interest of airports, airlines, passengers, and also to regulate the traffic of the aeronautical services. So these were the four important functions. To protect the interest of the three major stakeholders, that is airport, airlines, as well as the passengers. That was the first aim. And secondly, it aimed at regulating the traffic of aeronautical services. So what is meant by aeronautical services? Aeronautical services include services like navigation, surveillance, supportive communication for air traffic management, and also landing facilitation. So aeroplane landing facilitation. These are the major aeronautical services. So there were two important functions associated with the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India. The independent body, the independent aeronautical regulatory body, was responsible for the protection of the stakeholders, and secondly, to regulate the traffic for aeronautical services. Other functions of the regulatory authority was housing or parking the aircraft, ground safety, fuel handling, etc. along with the aeronautical services or the primary aeronautical services. So as we said, this was in the year 2008 and now it is 2018. Between these two periods, that is within a period of 10 years, the airline sector has changed a lot. So there is increased dependence on airlines, air traffic or aeroplane travel, and the dynamics of the airline sector has changed within this 10 years, and therefore the parliament or the government has introduced the new amendment bill. So let us see why there was a need for the amendment. First reason is workload. So as we said, in 2008, the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India was enacted. So from then till 2018, we have seen an exponential growth in this sector. As we said, the dependency on aircraft increased over a period of 10 years. So we have seen a tremendous growth in this sector. And there is also a huge increase in the number of airports. So when the demand for air travel increased, the number of airports also increased. And when the number of airports have increased, this has put a tremendous pressure or huge pressure on AERA. So with the existing provisions of the AERA 2008, it was difficult to manage all these airports. If we look at the statistics, we will understand that from the period of 2007 to 2017, if we take, the number of major airports in the country increased from 12 to 27. So it is more than double. And if we consider the minor airports, there has been numerous new minor airports coming up. And all this has led to an increase in the air traffic within the country. Another important fact is that a number of private operators also came into the picture. That is, a number of private operators entered the airport or airline sector. Again, there are many major airports that are run under public-private partnership, which we call as PPP. So all this has led to the changing dynamics. Or earlier, when the airports were owned by the government, it was easy to regulate. Now there are private operators because of liberalization, globalization and privatization. So private operators came into the picture. Again, the PPP model, where the government as well as the private entities have major role or equal role. So this also was introduced. So all this increased the pressure of the AERA because such provisions were not provided in AERA 2008. So with an increase in the pressure on the AERA, the efficiency of AERA or the independent regulatory authority came down. So when the efficiency came down, the tariffs as well as the monitoring services at major airports also became weak. So this was the reason why we needed an amendment in the existing AERA 2008. This is one major reason. Second major reason is the new dynamics that appeared in the airline sector during this years between 2007 and 2017. As we have discussed, private players came into the picture. Also, private-public partnerships or public-private partnerships also started playing a major role in this sector. So, with the entry of the private players or private players also taking part in the airline sector, several new business models came up. So, this business models like predetermined tariff or tariff-based bidding, especially in case of public-private partnership, all this dynamics came up. So, this were new to AERA. So, the already existing AERA did not have provisions to accommodate such business models like the predetermined tariff or the tariff-based bidding, etc. The entrance of the private sector has led to a structural change in the airport or airline sector. So, this structural change altogether changed the picture of the airline sector. What happened with the structural changes is that the market itself became the price determiners. So, in case of a competitive market or perfect competition, we have learned that under perfect competition, market is the price determiner. So, here also with the entrance of the private sector, the airline sector became a perfectly competitive market. And therefore, the forces of demand and supply determine the price of the products. So, when market has a major role to play in determination of prices, What is the role of the regulator? There is lesser role for the regulator. As we said, AERA is an independent regulator. So, with the entrance of the private sector and the airline market becoming perfectly competitive, the role of the AERA as a regulator came down. So, because of all these factors, the government had proposed this AERA Amendment Bill of 2018. Now let us see what does the AERA Amendment Bill of 2018 seeks to do. First of all, it tries to amend the definition of major airport. Under the AERA Act of 2008, a major airport is an airport with passengers of more than 1.5 million. So this is the passenger limit. If an airport has more than 1.5 million passenger traffic, an airport is classified as a major airport. But in the new amendment bill, the definition is proposed to be changed. Now, if an airport has more than 3.5 million passenger traffic, only then it will become a major airport. So, the threshold limit has been increased. So, why did the government intend to make a change in the definition of major airport? In order to bring down the number of major airports in the country. We have seen that from 12 to 27 is the increase. Now there are 27 major airports in the country. In the year 2008, when AERA was introduced, it was merely 12 airports. So the government wants to bring down the number of major airports in the country and wants to give a clear definition for major airports. Second important provision in this bill is that it tries to update Section 13 of the 2008 Act. What is Section 13 of the 2008 Act? This is an umbrella provision which covers the capital expenditure incurred and also the timely investment in improvement of airport facilities. So, two things are included, capital expenditure plus investments. We have seen that from 2008 till 2018, at present, the structure has completely changed. So, there are new business models and also new tariff system. So, in order to accommodate these changes, the Section 13 is proposed to be changed. So, a change in the Section 13 would mean that there will be changes in the tariff of aeronautical services at major airports. So, two important things are proposed to be changed. First one is definition of a major airport from 1.5 million traffic passengers to 3.5 million. So, this is the first important provision. And the second one is that the tariff of the aeronautical services at the major airports will be changed. So, these are the two important provisions that you should keep in your mind with regard to the AERA Amendment Bill of 2018. Now, quickly let us have a look at the bill summary. The Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India, that is AERA Amendment Bill 2018, was introduced in Lok Sabha during the monsoon session on July 18, 2018 by the Minister of State for Civil Aviation, Mr. Jayant Sinha. It tries to amend the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India Act 2008. Two important provisions of this bill. First one, as we have said, definition of major airports. So, the Act defines major airport as one with annual passenger traffic of over 15 lakh. This is with case of 2008 bill. So, according to the 2008 Act, it is 15 lakh. Now, the bill tries to increase the threshold of annual passenger traffic for major airports to over 35 lakh. So, 1.5 million to 3.5 million. That is the first major change. Second one is tariff determination by the AERA. So, under the Act, AERA is responsible for determining tariff for aeronautical services at different airports every 5 years. This is with regard to 2008 Act. Secondly, development fees of major airports, passenger service fee, etc. And what is the provision under the 2018 bill? The AERA will not determine the tariff structures, the developmental fees in certain cases, etc. So, what the AERA will do according to the new proposed bill, the AERA will be consulted before incorporating such tariffs and such tariffs must be notified. So, consultation is done with the AERA. So, it will not be the sole authority that determines the tariff. So, these are the two major amendments that are proposed in the new bill. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page. Thank you.
क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेनड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।